ordained. The vigil is the wake service, usually done the night before. Those are the rites that are celebrated between the time of death and the funeral liturgy, or should there be no funeral liturgy before the rite of committal. There is a small prayer service that's usually followed. Traditionally, what happens, though, is we pray the rosary. The rosary technically isn't part of the funeral rites, but it's something that everyone associates with the wake service. There's no problem with doing that. We're praying for the dead. Okay? The funeral liturgy itself provides two forms, one with a mass, one without a mass. So a liturgy of the word with final committal. If you have a priest celebrating, it's common to have a full mass. Okay? The only reason I wouldn't do a full mass is if the person wasn't Catholic or wasn't Christian and it was requested by the family, or there were extreme circumstances involved. Typically, when a deacon or a lay person celebrates the funeral rites, there is no mass because they can't do a consecration. Okay? But it has all of the parts, liturgy of the word, usually communion, and the prayers to the dead. And then the rite of committal is broken up into two different forms. One is when the final commendation is celebrated as part of the funeral liturgy. So we have mass at the church, we go directly to the cemetery for the burial. What's more common here in Alaska is the rite of committal with final commendation at a separate time. Like Keith explained in his talk, it's hard to bury a body at 40 below because we just don't have the ground thawed enough to be able to bury. Okay? Not to mention in some places, like in our native communities, you don't dig graves early. It's bad juju. You don't do that because you're inviting death. And so those things have to be taken into account as well. I think that's all I've got. Does anyone have any questions about our funeral rites? One of the things I want to end on, like I said, we have these booklets. I'm going to pass them out. Feel free to take one each or one for family, however you choose. I have encouraged all of my parishioners at Cathedral and here to start looking through these books and begin planning your funeral. There's nothing that says you can't have something on file in the parish with all of your funeral rites spelled out. It does several things. One, the preparation makes it easier for your family and for the priest. Because if you put a note in with your will or wherever you tell people to look if you pass away, they know that's one less thing that they have to do. But also, as I said before, it speaks to who you are and your faith. Because the readings are ones that you've chosen. The songs are ones that you've chosen. The people that you've asked to do readings or to be your pallbearers are all chosen by you, and so it speaks to who you are and your faith. But it's not so locked in that you can't come to me 6 months down the road and go, I've changed my mind. Okay? The only caveat I offer is this. If you choose music, as you know, our music changes on a fairly regular basis. If there's a particular song or hymn that you like, Xerox it. Stick it in with your stuff. Because it may not be there I'm hoping to have another 40 or 50 years. It may not be something that's in there. And if you want that, at least we have a copy of it and we can try to honor your last request. And then bring it to the church. I have a file cabinet, a file folder now with several of our parishioners on file, but also keep a set with your will, with your other significant documents. Okay? And if you've got questions about it, come and see me. Talk to your own pastors, because I'm sure that they would welcome that. It gives your family an opportunity to be able to mourn without having to deal with the specific arrangements, and it makes it so much easier for everyone, especially if you run into those odd occasions like Keith talked about where you have a family maybe that's not united, that it's no longer their responsibility to have to fight over those things because you've made those choices already yourself. Thank you for your time. We'll take about